The things I love and hate about a Rolls Royce Wraith. Would you buy a Rolls Royce Wraith? I bought one about 6 months ago, and today we're talking about the things that I love about it and the things that I maybe regret a little bit about buying this vehicle. Funny story, just starting off, the first week that I got the car, I valeted at a mall, but when I pulled up, there was a valet meters that were reserved for nice cars. So I parked the car. I was like, hey guys, you know, are you sure that you're gonna park it right there and you're not gonna move it? They're like, yep, we're gonna keep it close, don't worry. Cool, went into the mall, did my shopping, came out an hour or two later, gave them my ticket, and next thing you know, I see the car pulling out all the way around the corner through the parking garage. This is just fantastic. Long story short, they backed my car into a concrete wall the first week that I had it, and I had to pay $2,000 to fix the car. So that was just a quick funny story. But the first thing, I do not believe in buying cars brand new. I don't believe it. This car had about a $310,000 sticker price when it was new. I bought it 4 years old. So a new car, $310,000, but with the upgrades, which we'll go over here in just a second, it was a lot more than $310,000. So one of the coolest things I love about this car is the red interior. The red interior is my favorite color, and I needed the red when I got a vehicle. So the red just sets it off. It's just different than the white and the black out there. The next thing, which is really cool, if you look right here and you push this button, an umbrella pops out. So you have an umbrella with the Rolls Royce. I don't know if you'll be able to see that, but with the Rolls Royce initials on the umbrella, and it's on both sides of the vehicle. So you never have to worry about getting stuck in the rain. But you want to make sure you don't lose an umbrella, because those cost about $3,000 to $5,000 a piece. Another cool thing that I really like are the Persian rugs. I never knew they were Persian, but they're Persian rugs, and it's a $7,000 upgrade for Persian rugs. And then if you look into the ceiling, there's stars in the ceiling. So I always thought Rolls Royce Wraith had stars in the ceiling, but what I came to find out is less than 50% of the Wraiths have stars in the ceiling, because it's a five-figure upgrade just to get stars in the ceiling. And you can put stars in aftermarket for a lot less than that, but anytime you change a vehicle aftermarket, it could hurt the price of the vehicle. So I love the stars, one of my favorite features. Another really cool thing, which again, I thought all Rolls Royce had, are the RR in the headrests of the seats, but all these actually do not have the RR. Again, thousands of dollars just to put the RR in the headrest. So if I had to guess, and I don't know exactly, but I'm guessing this had about a $350,000 sticker to it with all the upgrades, and I bought it for just about half of that. So I bought it 4 years old with about 12,000 miles on it. Still a brand new car in my eyes at the end of the day. And I got it for 50% discount. So I definitely do not believe in buying cars brand new off the lot. Another thing that I love about this vehicle is that it's a conversation starter. So anytime I pull up in this and I get out of the vehicle, everybody looks like, oh my God, it's Rolls Royce. It's a beautiful thing, because people come up to me all the time like, hey man, like, what do you do? That's a beautiful car. And you gotta be interesting when you're talking to people. You can't say some generic thing like, oh, you know, I'm in real estate, or oh yeah, you know, I don't do anything. You gotta be interesting. So depending on who's talking to me, I pitch them on an opportunity. So if it's an older person, I tell them like, hey, yeah, you know, I'm in real estate, and I actually teach other people how to invest their money into real estate and earn double digit returns. I'm trying to raise private money. It creates conversation, it creates curiosity. And they might say like, how do you teach other people how to get double digit returns? Then you're hooked. Now you got them on a potential private money. Or if some young person comes up like, man, that's a beautiful car, what do you do? How do I get one? You know, actually, I'm a real estate developer and I teach other people how to do the same thing. So, hey, I teach them. Go to my YouTube channel. It's 100% free. If you want coaching from myself to learn how to build your own real estate investment company and get it to six or seven figures, I offer coaching as well. And by the way, there is a link in the description below that does have my coaching program. If that's something you're interested in, definitely check it out. But it's a beautiful thing just to have conversations. It also allows me to get into rooms that I never thought I would have gotten into before. So just pulling up in this, they see you as having a level of success. Whether you do or don't, that's what they visualize it at. So being able to shake hands with the right people, get into the right rooms, go to car shows, and be able to eat dinner with those types of people, it's all worth it to me just to be able to have those types of conversations, which builds my network, which builds my net worth. And one of my favorite features on the Rolls Royce is the ecstasy. And when you lock it and unlock it, it goes up and down. I always saw that in the music videos, but being able to have it yourself is a cool thing as well. And then something that I've never really paid attention to, I've never been a big car person. I just saw the Rolls Royce and I fell in love with it at a very young age. But something that this vehicle does have is it has a V12 motor in it, which is a big motor. But the problem with this vehicle is that it's so big and so heavy that the V12 really doesn't get that much power to make it go fast because it's an enormous vehicle. And one of the last things that I love about this vehicle is that the doors can close on themselves. So if you push this button, the door closes. So a couple negatives about the vehicle, and honestly, there's really not that many negatives. But one thing is that even though it does have 624 horsepower in it, it's not that fast of a vehicle, like I said before, because it's so heavy. It weighs over 5,000 pounds. It's a very heavy vehicle. One of the other negatives is that the vehicle's like almost as long as a Cadillac Escalade extended version, because it feels like it's a two-door coupe, but it feels like a four-door sedan. I get people that sit in the back seat all the time and they're like, oh my gosh, like there's so much room back here. So this is a big car. It's a full-blown sedan. It's not a sports car, you know, speed demon by any means. So, you know, that is a negative because it's not fast. But when you buy a vehicle like this, you know, it's not meant to be like a Lamborghini or a Ferrari or anything like that. And then the last thing that I was pretty scared of when I first bought the vehicle, and everybody talked about it, is the upkeep, is how much it costs to keep the car up. They told me that the oil changes were going to be like $1,500. Just because it's a more expensive car and you got to take it to a specific dealership to do the work on it, because it's a car that, you know, most people don't work on. So when I first took it to get an oil change, I was definitely nervous a little bit to get the bill, but the bill only came back at like $350. So it wasn't bad at all. The maintenance thus far has not been bad. Now, they did mention that some of the vehicles do have leaks in the oil pan sometimes, and that's a $5,500 fix just for one little leak. So it can add up depending on what goes wrong, but so far in my experience, the upkeep hasn't been bad at all. So if you're gonna ask me if this was a good investment, the answer is absolutely not. A vehicle like this is not an investment just for the vehicle, but if you're gonna ask me, would I buy the vehicle again? It'd be an absolute yes, without a doubt, no questions asked. One, because it's been a dream of mine since I was a kid. I used to drive a Chrysler 300 in high school because it's the closest thing that I could afford to a Rolls Royce. So I've always wanted it, so I would absolutely buy it again for that reason. And the second reason is because to me, it actually kind of does break down to be an investment. Because when you're driving around in this and you're having the conversations that you can have, that turns into opportunity, that turns into money, that turns into JV deals, that turns into people selling me their real estate deals, which I'm making money on, which in turn pays for the vehicle. And last but not least, I get motivation every time I think about it or see it. It hypes me up and keeps me motivated. So I'm curious what your dream car is. Drop a comment in the comment section below. Let me know what your dream car is. And while you're down there, make sure you hit that like button. YouTube loves that algorithm. That'd be greatly appreciated. And as always, appreciate you being here, and we'll see you on the next one.